What's up, YouTube? I'm your boy, Big Mike. This is, of course, another episode of Sneaker Editions. And today, we're going to talk about my top sneakers every guy should own. Let's get it.
Yeah. Turn my music up. Come on. Turn my music up. Come on. Talk shit now.
Going over these sneakers, we're going to have certain, I guess, styles and categories, of course, that every guy should own or every sneakerhead should have in their collection. Let's get into it. All right, let's start it off with the retro, okay? Retro in this category can be, of course, the retro is a given of a Jordan brand, okay? But it can also be like any signature shoe that you love. Okay, any signature shoe that you want to put in that retro category, you can put in there. That's the best thing about sneakers. They can almost fit in any category that we name in this video today. You can put any sneaker that I might have in a category. You can switch it and put it in a different category. That's the beauty of a sneakerhead. You love what you want. You wear what you like, and you do what you want to do. Let's go. So my first sneaker for the retro, bam, of course, I'm biased. Y'all know, Jordan 1s, man, and the Jordan 1 bread. What better Jordan 1 to have up here than the Jordan 1 bread? Now, when we say retros and you put up a Jordan 1, do not put up a Jordan 1 mid, people, unless you just have a great desire and it's your heart, which I don't see it being so. But Jordan Brand is trying to make them hype again. But they've never been hype, in my opinion. You got to have that Nike Air on the tongue, baby. On the tongue. And an iconic bread colorway is the way to go for a Jordan 1, which I have a lot back here you can choose from, but a lot of people might want to go with Hypebeast, with a Hypebeast Jordan 1 or something like that, but this is one of your more expensive Jordan 1s, but they cost $160, man. Jordan 1s are cheap and affordable, and you can get them now. You might not be able to get this pair for affordable price right now, but you can get a lot of Jordan 1s for affordable prices. Just a great iconic sneaker for a Jordan retro. And you might not go for the Jordan 1. You might go for a 4, 5, 11, 6, 12. Well, who knows? Retros are endless. Endless pieces. Moving on, man. You got to put the iconic, bam, Air Force 1 up in here, man. And this is my daughter's pair. One of her old pairs, really. A white Air Force 1. You can get them in white, black. Whatever, I had to put the beater up here, man. The beater, a sneakerhead is gonna have a beater, okay? You're gonna have a beater. And I chose her beaters because my beaters are not quite to a beaten point where it looks like this yet, because I try to take care of my shoes, every shoe. I don't care if it's a beater shoe or whatever. You gotta clean them and take care of them. And hers are made it to that point. So these are almost at the, well, they're at the throwaway stage, but these, she can use these to clean up the yard, go pick up some groceries in, or, you know, do some outside routines now because they're to that point. That's the beauty about sneakers. You can transfer them down to different stages. Okay, bam. Wore my casual shoes. Now they're moving down to the yard shoes. Wore my yard shoes. Now it's moving down to throwaway. You got three stages you can go to. Beautiful thing being a sneakerhead, baby. Beautiful thing. This being a historic shoe, and they're coming back with collabs and stuff. Can't go wrong with the Air Force 1. Next up, let's go. The next shoe that I think every man should own in a collection, bam, is the Air Max Silhouette. Now, it could be a lot of different Air Maxes out there, baby. So you got to fall into one of them. One of them you got to pick. You got to love one of them. Air Max 90s, Air Max 1s, either one of these. You got the Air Max 97s, which I have a lot of over there. You have the Air Max 98s. You have the Air Max, what, 93s, I think. Air Maxes are just a dope shoe. And they're pretty much comfortable where everybody can wear them. And you can pretty much wear them, get away with running them casually, get away with running in them, and get away with working out in them. It's just a shoe that we need here in the sneaker game today. I thank God for the 90s. 90s brought great things. Beautiful. Beautiful. Next up, we're going to get into some classics, man, that you can wear with your day you want to wear, go out and let's see, what would be the perfect occasion for it? You want to have a downtown stroll, or you want to have a walk with the wifey, or, you know, because when I want to have a walk or downtown stroll, or walk with the wifey or something, and we're going out to have a comfortable afternoon, and I want to be relaxed, You know what I'm saying? I put on a pair of chinos. So we're going to talk about some shoes that you need to wear with a pair of chinos, man. Okay? And of course, Jordan 1s, you can definitely put off of chinos, okay? Let's get that out of the way right now. Jordan 1s, if that's been a topic for you and thinking about that, definitely can rock with chinos because your boy Big Mike do that, okay? We do that. And I'm talking about as a bigger guy, we do that. And if you want me to, I can drop videos about how to dress as a big guy because you know your boy. Well, I ain't bragging. All right, but anyways... we'll get into some shoes that you can wear with some chinos, and you gotta have these in your collection. In my opinion, you need some type of low top sneaker in your collection. They could be Jordan 1s, they could be Chuck Taylors, a lot of stuff. But the shoes I chose today, we're gonna go ahead and get into them. Bam! Shout out to MrRed_King, my boy, for sending these joints over, man. You see, I ain't even broke this part of the way out. The red pair I have broke out. You know what I'm saying? You got a pair of Puma suede joints, man. These joints are actually, this is a dope colorway. He sent me a red colorway and a blue colorway. And this colorway is fire. Just any kind of shoe that's low top like this, you can get away with wearing with your casual dress chinos, man. And you can just pull it off. You can actually wear these with denim and shorts and everything else, man. Just another casual shoe. Puma has been in the game for a long time. They're coming back strong, actually. And you'll see another sneaker I got in this list that is Puma exactly as well. But yeah, the first shoe that you can wear, Pumas. Next shoe I had to throw it in is the Vans, man, okay? I would have been in big trouble to a lot of people out there, a lot of my viewers out there, and a lot of sneakerheads in general. If I didn't put the one of the best skateboard shoes, casual shoes, slash AKA shoes you can wear with anything, the Vans up here, man. A lot of people rock Vans. And I have a couple pair, and this is happened to be one of them, and I love this colorway that I bought it in. Dope colorway with the gum bottom. Sets off this Van up. This is a dope shoe. And Vans are just a statement piece, history. A lot of Californians out there on the West Coast, in general, wear this shoe for an everyday shoe. And this is actually dope, man. It has a leather inside on this one. And it's very similar to a Chuck Taylor Converse that could have also fell in this category. Moving on. Okay, moving on, man. So it is 2020, people. 2020, and you need a certain hypebeast shoe in your collection, whether it's gonna be a Jordan sneaker that's hypebeast that you can actually choose from. I'm not gonna pick one because I have a lot of Jordan sneakers, okay? And you can actually pick from anywhere from Yeezy or other categories, Off-White, everything else that is hype beast. You need at least one hype beast shoe in your collection, because the reason I say you need it now in 2020, because most of the hype beast shoes you can get some kind of way. There's other ways to get them. If you miss out on the drop for that day, you usually have chances to get them off StockX and GOAT and other sneaker consignment stores that are out there and they're available for you to purchase. If they're a little too high for you, I totally get that and understand. Now, I'm not down to anybody who doesn't have a hypebeast shoe or anything like that. But it's 2020, and hypebeast culture is kind of taking over. So I got to go ahead and lean with the people, okay? I'm for the culture. I'm for the culture, people. Let's get into one of the shoes that everybody could own. You might be disagreements. That's the best thing about hypebeast shoes, disagreements on a lot of stuff, okay? There's a lot of disagreements out there. I disagree with some of the hypebeast shoes that people own, but it's the culture. Bam. Fear of God, one. I know. Now, to me, these are fire. Dope. I spent a lot of money for these because I wanted to rock this sneaker with certain fits. I want to be that cool person with the Fear of God one. I want people to look at me and say, hey, he wearing Fear of God ones. Fear of God ones. Some people love this shoe. Some people don't. It's just one of those hate and love crime scenes that we see a lot in the sneaker game. In general, these are fire. It's one of the first of the two OG colorways, which is, this is the light bone, and the other one was the black pair. I personally picked the light bone because of the materials that's on the pair, and to me, it's just a basic, better pair of all the colors that came out in Fear God. Other than those yellow joints, those are fine. The next and final category is the dad shoe. Yes, own it, love it, accept it. It's 2020. We thought that this trend would die in 2018, 2017, when it started coming across. And it can't really just, and I got to thinking about it. How can it die when it actually started in the 80s and 90s? Dads were walking around the era of monarchs years, years ago. So how can it die when it started then? And then it trends, as we know, people, it's a circle of life. Trends come and they go. That being said, the dad shoe is dope in my opinion. And I have a couple of pairs of the dad shoe that we're going to go ahead and show right now. One being the Hypebeast shoe. Bam! The Yeezy 700 Wave Runners, y'all.
Look.
For the Yeezy fans, I know you are clapping and applauding right now. Big Mike just showed the Yeezy on the channel. Yes! And for comfortability, this is the most comfortable shoe that I have in my collection. Outside of the Jordan 2 just done, because Jordan 2s are way comfortable, y'all. If you don't have a pair of Jordan 2s, go get you some. But anyways, these right here are just fire, dog. The colorway's dope. I said for a long time that I was against Yeezy because I wasn't against Kanye per se. I was just against the Yeezy brand and what they're producing. To me, the 350s and all that, and the 750s and all that up to this point when they released this 700 Wave Runner, I felt none of them. I wasn't feeling none of those pairs, none of those silhouettes, no colorway. But this particular model, the 700 Wave Runner, this shoe right here now, and I don't even like the other colors that's out there. Except for maybe the all gray pair. I don't know the name of the Yeezys. Like the all gray pair with the orange hints on the side. Those are fire. I think they're like the inerts or in something. He's got some crazy names for shoes. But these 700 Wave Runners are fire and by far are the best Yeezy, in my opinion, to drop. And that is falling on their dad shoe category is just dope. These make every outfit look fire. I actually had a conversation with my boy, John the other day on Instagram, and we were talking about how these were actually making every outfit look fire. He was against Yeezys and stuff too, and now he's actually wanting a pair of these Wave Runners, and I can't really blame you, John, because these joints, man, just go ahead and fall in love with them and fall in love to the stream of the Yeezy hype for this shoe. I'm not saying for every shoe. I know there's a lot of Yeezy fans out there, and that's cool, but for this shoe, y'all right on. I'm rocking with you. 700s, dopeness. The last dad shoe we're going to talk about is This company has made a splash back onto the scene. They actually made a splash back onto the scene in the year of 2019 in general, because at the end of 2018, they were dropping some dope colorways and knocking it back out of the park and getting back into the basketball shoe scene and everything else. I'm talking about the Pumas, people. These are the RSX Toys. And for me, this colorway is fire. Now, they do have a new version of the RSX, and it's like an RSXSE or whatever it's called, something. The trainer looks a little bit different than this. They want to look like a little bit narrower in the back here in the heel, and it's not as wide. But for me, this right here was a dope-ass shoe to come out with. Dope colorway, probably the best colorway in the RSX, in my opinion. And I was able to, you're able to pick these up cheap for cheap people. It's a dad shoe that you can wear cheap, and it also looks great on feet. This is a dope colorway. I love it. It's comfortable. I mean, like I'm saying to you, man, I think as far as size, you can go up half a size, or if you like a snug fit, go to true to size. I went true to size because I like the snug fit. But in some shoes, in shoes like these, yes, sir. I mean, it's like I said, it's the different type of dad shoes are endless. There's other different types of dad shoes out there. If you want to go high, Hypebeast with the Balenciagas and them, they get outrageous with how they look. You know, you can go different ways with the Hypebeast dad shoes, man. But anyways, there's other Nike dad shoes also. But anyways, with that being said, people, that concludes today's video. Of the top sneakers that every guy should own in their collection. I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you hit the like button. Hit that like button. It does works and does wonders for this channel. And I appreciate everybody, all the newcomers that's coming, subscribe. Hope this video is great for you. Hope you're loving the channel. Make sure you stay tuned for more content that's coming. Big Mike, Sneaker Editions, on the way up, on the road to 10K.